Hi guys, I'm Miss Waters from Tri-County Mental Health, and I'm here to talk to you about something called self-care. Self-care is basically making sure we take care of ourselves and our needs to do things that help us manage stress and be healthy in our lives. It includes taking care of our emotions, our physical body, our social relationships, like those with family and friends, and other things that we'll explore in this video. Let's take a closer look at self-care. Some people think that self-care is selfish, but what we've found from research and interviewing people around the globe is that when you feel rested and nourished, cared for, and supported, you actually have more energy to help other people. Sometimes people think that they don't have time to do things for themselves, or that self-care might take a lot of time, when actually acts of self-care can happen throughout the day for tiny snippets of time. For instance, taking 30 seconds to do some deep breathing, making sure you eat nutritious meals, making sure you chat with a friend and reach out and connect with them, and even just being in school and engaging yourself in learning something new can all be forms of self-care. Self-care isn't a one-time experience. It's something that you continue throughout your life and as you grow. It helps you build what we call resilience, which means the ability to make it through difficult times and bounce back. Right now, our focus as a society is on the act of being healthy and safe, making sure we cover our cough and wipe our noses, dispose of Kleenex, and for sure, washing our hands. Remember to sing the happy birthday song twice in your head and suds up while you do it. That is how long it takes to get your hands super clean and kill virus germs. Also, going to the doctor or dentist when you are sick and having annual checkups is a part of self-care as well. If you're in sports, having your annual sports physical is a part of good self-care too. All of these show you're respecting your body. One of the biggest things we can do to take care of ourselves is to get enough sleep. It can be super difficult to get enough sleep as a kid, also as an adult. But you also need it to be healthy and grow, as well as manage your emotions, to get your brain ready to learn new things, and to have energy to do all the things you want to do. When you look at this chart, you can see that kids between the ages of 6 and 12 years old require between 9 and 12 hours of sleep. That means if you wanted 12 hours of sleep and you needed to get up at 7 o'clock in the morning, you'd have to go to bed by 7 o'clock at night. That's not realistic for a lot of kids. Remember, taking a nap is also an option. The best way to make sure you get good sleep and have what we call sleep hygiene is making sure that you go to bed around a certain time and get up at a certain time. Of course, there will be times when you might be playing a game late or staying over at a friend's house or even having a special movie night where you stay up late. And doing that once in a while is fine. But if you do it for the majority of the time, to be taking care of yourself, it's best to get sleep by a certain time every night. If you are 13 and wanting to get 8 hours of sleep and have to be up by 7 in the morning, that means you would need to be in bed and asleep by 11 o'clock the night before. If you want more sleep, you have to adjust the time and get to sleep even earlier. Other things that can help with sleep are turning off your screens on your computer, your phone, and video games at least 1 hour before bedtime. Doing some deep breathing, mindfulness, and meditation prior to bed, and we'll talk more about that later. Even doing a little slow yoga can help. Managing social media is another way to engage in self-care. So many times we can get caught up in a post or comments or conversation that might not be positive and healthy. Taking a social media break and even just a media break from the news and TV can be super helpful in the act of self-care. Limiting time that you play video games can be helpful too. And always make sure you're being safe and practicing good online digital citizenship. It respects yourself, your ideas, and those around you. Of course, connecting safely with your friends is important as well. Another huge thing we can do to help with our own self-care is to keep an attitude of gratitude. When we think positive thoughts, it helps us to see and think more positively. And sometimes, even when things around us are seemingly really bad or negative, looking towards the positive can help us get through those tough times. You might want to consider starting a gratitude journal where you go through and list a few things every morning or night, or even both, that you are thankful for. You could make it an art journal. You could create a gratitude jar in your home and even create gratitude stickies for your phone. There are apps too that can help us think of positive affirmations or positive thoughts and gratitude statements if we have trouble thinking of some. Speaking of creating, did you know that being creative is one big way to manage stress and engage in self-care? Painting, putting together collages like scrapbooks, drawing, sewing, working with clay are all different kinds of art activities that you can do. Singing, being in a choir or a musical production, doing online karaoke, being in a band and writing poetry, stories, or in a journal is a creative way of doing creative self-care. Just make sure that you're enjoying what you do. Spending time with friends and family in scouts or social and faith-based groups you may be interested in, organized sports, book clubs, are more ways that you can contribute to developing your self-care. Remember to take some time, though, and not fill your schedule up too much. Moving your body through physical activity is one of the best ways to manage stress as well, because when you move your body, you release the stress that's stored in your muscles, as well as releasing different stress hormones. We can't forget the importance of good nutrition and eating right. The more food you eat, like vegetables, fruits, and lean meats, the better you feel, because nutrition is readily available to fuel your body's cells. This isn't to say that junk food should be out altogether, but managed in moderation. Sharing good food and even learning to cook to help your family can be a fun way to explore food, as well as learning to take care of yourself nutritionally. Engaging our minds is a form of self-care too. Things like Lego Club, robotics, coding, exploring different skills in computers, building history, getting outside and exploring nature are all ways we can engage in self-care. Many times you can go on a hike or even just go sit under a tree, and that can be a great way to relax. Sometimes things happen in our lives, our families, and with our friends, or even in our city and country that can stress us out. Learning coping skills and strategies to manage stress is really vital to healthy self-care. These strategies can be as simple as taking a few minutes to stop what you're doing and breathing deeply, moving your body to let the stress out of your muscles, listening to some music that is positive, calming, or even that you just like to sing along to. Talking to a friend, a family member, or a teacher for support can also help you engage in some coping skills and help problem solve what might be bothering you. Let's try a simple breathwork practice right now. All you need to do is sit up straight. Breathe in through your nose for a count of four, trying to fill your stomach up like a balloon. Then exhaling for a count of four, pushing all that air out. Then holding the breath for a count of four. Then breathe in for a count of four. Exhale for a count of four. And hold for a count of four. One more time, breathe in. Out and hold. Finally, it's important to put together a self-care plan that you can use as a guide to help you to prevent feeling overwhelmed or burnout, including downtime where you are relaxing and doing nothing is absolutely okay, and actually a good thing in learning that we don't have to be busy all the time. It's this example of a self-care plan is for a daily approach where you would list out how you will take care of your body, maybe by exercising, eating nutritiously, and getting sleep. And also your emotional needs, maybe connecting with friends, sharing your emotions through art, with a family member, a teacher, or a therapist. It also includes picking an affirmation for the day, that positive go-to statement that can help redirect any negative thinking. You can use a quote as well. You don't have to make one for every day. You can always just have a general plan, a weekly plan, or even a monthly plan. There are also lots of self-care calendars full of different things and ideas for providing yourself self-care on the internet. Having an emergency care wall or plan as a go-to for feeling really strong emotions or upsets can be a big help too. It can include a friend's phone number who you can talk to, or a warm line phone number or text number. A warm line is a place you can call when you are not in crisis, but just need someone to talk to. You can also contact a crisis line if you feel like you are in crisis via phone or text. In your emergency care wall or plan, you can have a favorite movie written down, a playlist developed to help you, a comfy blanket, or maybe your favorite set of clothes, or a sweatshirt, or a comfy pair of pajamas. Even a stress ball or a stuffed animal or favorite pillow to snuggle. Anything that is calming and soothing and comfortable to you. Remember, there are tons of ways that you can engage in self-care. And the cool thing is, you're probably already doing some of these things. And you can do them at home, outside, inside, or even at school. Actually, you can basically do them anywhere. You have to breathe and eat to live, right? So purposefully making good choices that are healthy helps make a happier, healthier you.